Hello, and today we're with Mr. Rashed Alshammari, who is the Vice President of Commercial for the Saudi Air Connectivity Program of the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. Good afternoon to you, Rashed.
Yeah, nice meeting you.
It's very nice to meet you. Now, here we are on the first day of Routes Asia 2024 in Langkawi, Malaysia. What is the objective of the Air Connectivity Program being here in Langkawi?
Thank you for your question. The air connectivity program, the Saudi air connectivity program objective is to unlock the potential opportunity for the Asian route and Asian market. We as an air connectivity program play a key role enabling the connectivity to the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia by catering and the partnership with our airlines, tour operators, airport, name it, to explore and unlock the Saudi market within Saudi Arabia.
What objectives does your company have for 2024?
Okay, the objective of our organization, we are a governmental body, is to boost the inbound tourism in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. We work with our ecosystem to enable the growth in terms of adding more seats capacity, and should generate more inbound passenger and tourists to explore and identify Saudi Arabia. And this is our key role. We enable the connectivity in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia as a bridge between aviation and tourism.
How will you measure those objectives? That is, as you mentioned, you've outlined the role of the Saudi Air Connectivity Program.
Yes.
In terms of objectives, how will you measure the success for 2024? What are your objectives for this year?
This is a great question. We, an air connectivity program, we monitor the growth of air connectivity, air connectivity when it comes to new destination to the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. And when I'm saying air connectivity is like adding more capacity, adding more new destination, grow existing capacity, recover from COVID level. And then to measure that success, we said, okay, listen, we brought that number of seats, how we can secure the demand and generate more passenger when it comes to adding more capacity and seats capacity. And this is one pillar of our performance measure.
In terms of new routes which are going to be launched in 2024, what new routes are being launched this year?
This year it will be a game changer in air connectivity. We will launch multiple destinations from the other side of the world, like in Europe and Far East Asia, name it, and other destination. We will be launching multiple destination, and please keep close eye on air connectivity press release. You will hear a lot in the upcoming month what is the new destination that will be upcoming for Saudi Arabia.
In terms of technology, what new technology is on the horizon that you're most excited about, that you feel will change the Saudi air connectivity program the most?
I believe in the air connectivity program, we do not look only at the capacity aircraft side. Also, we took into consideration the passenger cycle. We want to have a seamless travel experience. And the technology is one of the enabler to smooth the experience of the passenger. I'm telling you, today the passenger, when he come or she come to a country, the first point or stop point will be the airport. We need to enhance the experience, the passenger experience, the seamless travel, and even not just the airport, beyond the airport, like going outside of the airport, visiting the city. So the technology will play a key role in enhancing the seamless travel and to satisfy the passenger needs or the tourist experience.
As Saudi Arabia expands and the air connectivity grows, you can learn from a lot of airports around the world.
Yes.
Which are some of the airports that you look at the most in terms of learning experience that Saudi Arabia has looked at and has learned from? Which are some of the airports you look at?
This is a great question. We at Air Connectivity Program, we take into consideration all different type of business model airport. Like if you tell me like in terms of operational excellence, we will benchmark with the best airport that have that segment of expertise or the best in class airport for operations. When it comes to the passenger experience, the environment, atmosphere, we will benchmark with the best in class airport in that one, because at Air Connectivity we care about the passenger experience, the tourist experience, and a seamless travel with benchmarking with the best in class airport in a specific function or area of expertise in that area.
If we were to sit down in 10 years' time from now, what sort of numbers do you think we would be looking at in terms of Saudi Arabia's arrival numbers? What sort of numbers are we looking at, do you think, in 10 years? What's the goal?
Yeah, this is, again, it's another great question, my friend. We, as one of the Vision 2030 enabler when it comes to developing the tourism sector, plus we enabler for the aviation strategy. When it comes to the inbound tourism, we are targeting to have up to 150 million inbound tourists to the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia by 2030. And I'm telling you, before we said it's ambitious, but I'm telling you now it's realistic. We will make it happen. On the other side, we are considering the aviation sector strategy. When it comes to the total traffic of passenger, we are targeting to add more than 250 destinations with a 330 million passenger traffic, whether inbound, outbound, the transfer passenger. And this is the number that we are. I'm seeing it from now for 10 years period.
And finally, we are in Southeast Asia now. Which are your most important markets here in Southeast Asia? Where are you concentrating your marketing efforts for this region?
We at Air Connectivity Program, when we identify the market, we look at the gap of air connectivity, the direct destination. Where we have gap in air connectivity, we will consider it as a priority, whether it is from the east or the west. And this is one of the main pillar of how identifying the route. Is it underserved? Is it unserved market? Or we need to grow capacity. And from that, we will take into consideration our targeted market.
Excellent. Well, Rashed, I have to say thank you very much indeed for your time today. And of course, I wish you and everybody at the Saudi Air Connectivity Program the very best of luck for the future. Shukran.
It's a pleasure. And I would like to invite you and to invite anybody who's looking at this interview to come and experience Saudi Arabia. Come and see, and you will enjoy it, and you will have a good experience. Thanks again, and wish you a good luck.
Thank you.